Hello, my dear students. How are you all? This is again Zeba Anjum for your computer applications with BlueJay Class 10th. So, my dear students, on 6 May 2020, I have given you a revision test. Have you seen it? In case you have seen the test and in case you have attempted the questions, then only you can see this video. So today's video lecture is specifically to give you the solutions of all the questions that I have given you in the revision test. So shall we start? From the first question, see, you have to find out the output. Now let us zoom this thing out. Over here, we are having two if statement. Yes, one thing merged inside the other one. Now see students, this is your bigger if statement, okay? And this curly bracket opened, and in this curly bracket your if statement as well as your else statement is contained. And aapka ye jo if statement hai, ye yahan par open hokar and yahan par ye off ho raha hai. Okay, so within this if bracket, within those curly bracket, aapka ek individual if else lie kar raha hai. Okay, so firstly we will see the bigger if condition is true or false. So you have the condition A less than B. So the value of A is 10, the value of B is 20. So 10 less than 20 condition is true. Hence it will evaluate this statement. Okay, so we have moved now inside your bigger if statement. Now let us see about this condition, ki ye condition aapki true hoti hai ya nahi hoti hai. Okay, 10 greater than 20 condition is clearly your false one. Okay, so aapki if condition execute nahi hogi, your else portion will be executed. So for this question your output will be what? Only welcome. You will be getting only welcome on the computer screen. So in case you have marked this second answer welcome, then please give yourselves 2 marks. Okay, otherwise very honestly, please give yourself 0 mark. Now moving forward, we are having the second question, that is, what is the value stored in variable RES given below? See my dear students, this was the expression that we were supposed to solve. Now see, this expression is basically merged. Okay, math.pow and math.sqrt we are having. So firstly we have to find out what? Math.square root. So math.square root of 225, we know that under root of 225 is what? It is 15. Yes, so now we have to find out math.pow 15, 2. Okay, the first argument will be your base value and the second argument will be the power. So you have to find out what? 15 square. So anyhow you will be getting what? 225. Okay, but it math.pow will give you what? It give you the results in decimal. So you will be getting 225.0 over here, and over here also 15.0 you will be getting. Okay, so your answer will be what? 225.0. Now students, this question completely was of 2 marks, and if you have done only this part, this math.square root part, then please give yourself 1 mark. And if you have done this completely, please give yourself 2 marks. Okay, and if you have written only 225, then please give yourself 1.5 mark. Okay, please be very honest with your marking. Now moving towards your third question, give 1 point of difference between your unary and binary operator. Now unary and binary operator, you have to point out only one difference. Okay, I have given over here what? Unary operators work on a single operand. Only a single operand it will be working on. Example, plus plus minus minus, it means post and pre. Okay, post increment, post decrement, pre increment and pre decrement. We have solved some examples also regarding those. Now for the binary, binary are those that work on two operands. Okay, two operands it will work on. Likewise your addition, multiplication, subtraction, modulus and all those things. Okay, so according to me that is the one difference, but it could be another one. The answer could differ. Okay, so in case you are having any different answer, then please let me know in the comment section and I will tell you whether your answer is correct or not. Okay, now there is no limitation or there is no foundation for you to give these examples over there. In case aapne examples diye hain, then you will be having a plus point. In case question mein mention nahi kiya gaya hai, still you have given an example, no worries. But इफ़ इन क्वेश्चन इट हैज़ बीन मैंशन कि आपको एग्जाम्पल देना है एंड आपने नहीं दिया है, देन योर मार्क्स विल बी रिड्यूस्ड. ओके, सो ओवर हेयर इन द क्वेश्चन इट हैज़ नॉट बीन मैंशन दैट यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट द एग्जाम्पल्स, सो क्लियरली यू विल बी गेटिंग कम्प्लीट मार्क्स, दैट इज़ टू. ओके, सो इफ़ योर आंसर मैचेज विद माइन, प्लीज़ गिव योर सेल्फ 2 marks. नाउ मूविंग फॉरवर्ड, फोर्थ क्वेश्चन. ओके, ओवर हेयर यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट वॉट जावा एक्सप्रेशन फॉर equivalent mathematical expression. Now see my dear students, the first one over here we are having what? Mod. For mod what we apply? We apply math.apps. okay, in the initial level we have given int ab. Why? Because math.apps only depends on the return data type of math.apps depends on the type of argument. In case you are taking integer arguments, then it will be going to give you an integer as a return type, and if you are going to get a double as an argument, then it is going to give you a double as a return data type. So that is why it is very important that you firstly define what kind of values you are going to take. So over here if we have defined that we are going to take integer variables, then by using this expression we can clearly find out that your resultant will be of integer. Okay, in case you have used double AB, then you have to use what? Double RES. Okay, it depends on you. Now regarding this complete expression, for this mod you have applied what? Math.apps. okay, now for the numerator we have applied this bracket a minus b divide by again bracket a plus b. I hope this answer is clear. And at the last you have to apply what? Semicolon also you have to apply. Okay, so if you have done like this, please give yourself 2 marks. In case you have not written the first line but only the second line you have written, then please give yourself 1 mark. Okay, now moving forward, see the second question. The second question is this one over here, a plus b to the power n. Then clearly what we will be using? Math.pow for numerator. Okay, so math.pow in brackets what we are having, base value is a plus b. Okay, so we are going to enclose it within your brackets and the power is n, so comma n. 2 arguments at a total we have taken, yes, and divide by under root 3 plus b. So for this under root we are going to give you what? Math.square root. So math.square root and in bracket you will be using 3 plus b over there. Okay, and at the last semicolon. Both these functions will be returning what? Your double data type. So anyhow the resultant will be is of double data type. Okay, I hope you have done this correct one. Yes, so please give yourself 2 marks. In case not, then accordingly you please mark yourself. Okay, for the third one again we are having some numerators and as well as some denominators, so brackets we are going to use it over here also. Yes, so 5x cube, I have written here 5 into x into x into x 3 times. You can also use like this 5 into math dot pow, then base value is x and the power is what? 3. You can also use like this. Okay, it depends on you, both the ways are correct. Now plus 2y, so 2 into y, numerator should be enclosed within what? Your bracket. Now divide by x plus y, again this x plus y will be enclosed in what? Bracket. And at the last you will be using this semicolon. Okay, now I have taken over here double, but if you are not using this math.pow then you can use over here integer also. But my dear students, you are dividing some quantity with other quantity and it is very much likely that you will be getting something in decimal number. Okay, matlab agar aap kisi quantity ko dusri quantity se divide kar rahe hain to zyada probability hoti hai ki aapka jo number hai wo decimal mein aayega, and for that kind of thing we have taken here what? Double. Okay, so in case you have done like this, please give yourself 2 marks. No, not exactly 2 marks students, this whole question is of 2 mark. Okay, so individual answer will be giving you half mark, so please change your marks accordingly. Aapka har ek part half marks ka hai, so please change your marks accordingly. Okay, now for the last one, see over here, please check your answer. I have used math.pow x comma 5 for x to the power 5, bx cube x comma 3, and for c it is being misprinted over there, plus c over there also. Okay, so this is your expression for the fourth one. दिस होल क्वेश्चन कंसिस्ट ऑफ टू मार्क्स नॉट जस्ट इंडिविजुअल पार्ट्स. ओके नाउ मूविंग फॉरवर्ड वी वर हैविंग अनदर आउटपुट बेस्ड क्वेश्चन. नाउ सी माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स द सेकेंड लाइन सेज वॉट सिस्टम डॉट आउट डॉट प्रिंट एल एन डायरेक्टली इट इज गोइंग टू गिव यू एन आउटपुट फर्स्टली. ओके फर्स्टली वॉट वी आर हैविंग मैथ डॉट मिन एंड सम मोर मैथमेटिकल फंक्शन इज इनक्लोज विद इन इट. ओके सो मैथ डॉट फ्लोर एक्स. सो एक्स वैल्यू वी आर हैविंग 2.9. इफ यू आर गोइंग टू कैलकुलेट द फ्लोर वैल्यू ऑफ 2.9 देन वॉट विल बी द वैल्यू. इट विल बी योर 2.0. ओके बिकॉज फ्लोर विल बी गिविंग यू द लोवेस्ट वैल्यू. येस द लोवेस्ट इंटीजर वैल्यू कॉमा वाई. वाई द वैल्यू ऑफ वाई इज वॉट 2.5 एंड एट द लास्ट यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट द मिनिमम वैल्यू अमंग 2.0 एंड 2.5. सो क्लियरली 2.0 यू विल बी गेटिंग एज एन आउटपुट. Okay, so first output is what? 2.0. Now you are having what? System.out.println. New line you are having. So that is why our next output will be on the next line. Okay, so for the next output, see over here. Math.max. Again, we are having math.seal enclosed within it. Okay, so math.seal x. The seal value of 2.9 will be what? It is 3.0. Okay, it is going to give you the higher value. Now, among 3.0 as well as 2.5, you have to find out the maximum value. Clearly, the answer is 3.0. So, you will be writing 3.0 over here. My dear students, if you have written the answer like this 2.0, 3.0, then your answer will be halfway right. Okay, give yourself 1 mark. In case you have written 2, 3, then again give yourself 1 mark. And if you have done like this, then only you give yourself 2 marks. Okay. Now, the last program that we are going to see over here. Okay. So, BSNL charges for using telephone from the customer according to the calls made. According to this chart, we have to make our program. Okay. Here, par dekhiye difference kya hai? Up to 50 calls. The next, your next row is depending on the previous one. Okay, for up to 50 calls, starting 50 calls, there will be no charges. For the next 100 calls, it means for the next 100, after 50 till 100, okay, you will be getting what? 1 rupee per call. And for the next 200 calls, you will be doing what? 90 paisa and so on. And at the last, what you have to do? Monthly rental charges is 180 rupees per month for all the customers. It means whether you lie in this category or this or this or this, you have to pay 180 rupees, okay? So, jitne aapke last mein charges aane hain, usme aap kya karenge? 180 ko plus kar denge, 180 plus charges, okay? To aapka wo total amount to be paid aa jayega yahan par. Now, what you have to do, see students, write a program to calculate monthly telephone bill indicating number. You have to take phone number as an input. Okay. Now, it depends that what kind of data type you have used for storing the number. Okay. Because integer is, I don't think so, your integer would be able to capture the number because your phone number is of 10 marks. Na? 10 numbers you are having in your phone number. So, you will be using different kind of data type within it. We are going to see how we are going to store a number, then number of calls for comparing these things, then amount to be paid, the total amount that you are going to pay after a month, that you have to calculate as well as you have to display. Now students, please check your answer with mine. This is a coding portion. Firstly, as usual, we have imported our Java class, java.util package we have imported over here, public class revision test, I have made a class revision test, okay, public static void main, all the normal things are here, yes, a scanner for taking input, sc we have made as an object, now over here we are taking telephone number as an input, now my dear students, see over here long num. Yes, for storing an integer variable, for storing an integer number, you will be storing a number in what? In long, because it is going to receive a 10 digit number. Yes, and your integer is having some kind of precision. So, aapka jo integer hota hai, wo bhi according to its priority, short, int and long mein divided hota hai. I hope you have studied these things in 9th class in depth. Okay, so I'm not going to tell you in depth over here, but yes, aapka integer ki itne zyada capacity nahi hoti hai that it can store 10 numbers. So anyhow, you will be using long over here. Okay, so over here we have used in long, then for storing number of calls we have taken integer, yes, because integer mein aapki calls aani hai. Double charges, a variable we have made by default, we have given it a value that is 0.0. now my dear students, regarding this if statement, see, if you have the cost less than zero, then there is no need to pay any charges. Yes, because you have not used any telephone lines. If you are having a telephone at your home, then you must be having a call. Yes, so आपका क्या होगा अगर आपने कॉल लेस देन ज़ीरो यहाँ पर इफ़ कंडीशन लिखी है, देन यू मस्ट हैव एंटर्ड सम काइंड ऑफ इनवैलिड नंबर. यस, आपने लेटर सपोज आपने बाई मिस्टेक -20 एंटर कर दिया है, देन इट शुड देर शुड बी समथिंग ना टू हैंडल सच काइंड ऑफ सिचुएशन. तो ये आपका माइनस में या फिर कुछ और ऐसे क्वान्टिटी के लिए वी आर गोइंग टू हैंडल दिस पार्ट. ओके, सो इफ़ कॉल लेस देन ज़ीरो देन यू विल बी डूइंग वॉट सिस्टम डॉट आउट डॉट प्रिंट एल एन यू हैव एंटर्ड इन इनवैलिड नंबर प्रोग्राम टर्मिनेट्स इट इज़ गोइंग टू गिव यू एन अप्रोप्रिएट आउटपुट. ओके, एंड देन आफ्टर दैट वॉट सिस्टम डॉट एग्जिट वी हैव ऑलरेडी लर्न अबाउट सिस्टम डॉट एग्जिट ये प्रोग्राम्स विल टर्मिनेट विदाउट एग्जीक्यूटिंग द फर्दर मोर एक्सप्रेशन. ओके, सो इन केस आपका ये वाला इफ स्टेटमेंट एग्जीक्यूट होता है देन यू विल बी गेटिंग वॉट सिस्टम डॉट एग्जिट जीरो तो आपका प्रोग्राम यहीं पर टर्मिनेट हो जाएगा विद दिस आउटपुट. ओके, सो दैट यू विल कम टू नो दैट ओके फाइन आपने इनवैलिड नंबर कुछ एंटर कर दिया है. ओके, गेटिंग द पॉइंट. इफ नॉट देन योर प्रोग्राम विल कंटिन्यू. नाउ सी ओवर देयर इफ एल्स कंडीशन वी आर गोइंग टू अप्लाई इट ओवर हियर. For the first 50 calls, your charges are zero. Okay. For the next 100, means already you have used the 50 calls. Next 100. So at a total, what happened? At a total, 150 आपकी calls हो जाती हैं. Yes, because 50 आपकी previous वाली and 100 आपकी जो आपकी next हैं. Okay. So at a total, we are having 150 calls. So accordingly, we are going to apply for the charges. Now see over here. For the first 50, we are having 0.0 charges. Yes, now remaining one, मतलब you will be having call -50, then जितनी आपकी remaining होंगी that should be multiplied by 1. Okay, let us take an example. In case आपने क्या किया है, you have used 120, you have made 120 calls. Okay, तो आपका क्या होगा, for the first 50 you will not be paying any charges. So for the first 50 you will be getting 0.0 and for the remaining one. Now remaining one आप कैसे calculate करेंगे, call minus 50 करके, because 50 के लिए तो आपने already charges apply कर चुके हैं ना. So that is why 120 minus 50 you will be getting what, 70. 70 multiplied by 1. Now this 70 calls will be charged according to 1 rupee. Okay, so 70 multiplied by 1, you will be getting what? Again, this 70. Okay, and now the answer will be 70. So at a total, yahan par aapko jo extra charge dena padega, wo 70 dena padega. Now getting the point. Now see, students, for the third row, you will be having what? Less than 200. Now 50 already you have used, for the next 100 also you have used, now for the next 200 we are talking about. So at a total kitne hogi aapke paas call, 50, 100, 200, you will be having what, 350 calls. Yes, so over here we have applied what, else if call less than equal to 350. Now see the charges, for the first 50 we have applied 0.0, for the next 100 we have applied rupees 1 per charge. Okay, and now for the remaining one, रिमेनिंग वन विल बी कैलकुलेटेड बाई कॉल माइनस 150 और वो आपका 0.90 के अकॉर्डिंग आपका कैलकुलेट हो जाएगा. ओके, नाउ फॉर द लास्ट वन, फॉर द लास्ट रो दैट इज ग्रेटर देन 350. येस, इन द क्वेश्चन इट हैज़ बीन मैंशन कि आपकी कॉल्स अगर 350 से ज़्यादा होती हैं देन फॉर द फर्स्ट 50 यू विल बी गेटिंग 0.0, फॉर द नेक्स्ट 100 यू विल बी गेटिंग दिस 100, फॉर द नेक्स्ट 200 यू विल बी गेटिंग 200 मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 0.90 एंड फॉर द रिमेनिंग पोर्शन यू विल बी गेटिंग वॉट, this remaining portion multiplied by 0.80. okay, I hope this if else if portion is clear to you. Now when you have calculated this charge, then you have to calculate the amount accordingly. Now we have seen that monthly rental charges of 180 has to be paid by every customer. Yes, so 180 plus charge, whether your customer lie in any of the category, it doesn't matter, but it has to pay 180 rupees as an extra charge. Okay, so amount aapka 180 plus charges ho jayenge. Now you have to print it out everything on the screen. Firstly the telephone number, then number of calls made, then charges to be paid, then amount to be paid. Okay, so this is basically your question. This was of 10 marks. So students, you can give your marks accordingly. It depends on you. I hope that you will be able to judge that how you are going to check. Yes, for the, in the 9th class also you have seen the checking, so accordingly you please give your marks. Okay, now Now let us see the kind of output that we are going to get for this question. That is your, see the first one, enter the telephone number. I have entered a number, okay, over here. I have entered a number, number of calls. So I have given you what? Minus 20. Yes, it is a wrong input. So you have got an appropriate message. That is, you have entered an invalid number, program terminates, and your program terminates in actual. Okay. Now see the second output. Enter the telephone number, done. Number of calls, done, 120. Now you will be getting this output. Telephone number, this one. Number of calls, this one. Charges to be paid and total amount to be paid. Okay, so these are your outputs. See, students, in the examination or in your copy, again and again I am telling you that there is no need to write down the output portion. Output is mandatory only when you are in the lab, you are going for the practical, on your practical files, then only your this output is important, okay. But regarding your theory portion, regarding your questions and answers, unsolved programs, regarding your copy and exams, all those things, your output is not mandatory. You are not going to get any extra marks in these outputs, okay. So please keep this thing in your mind. Now this is the end of this video. I hope you all will be getting good marks. Yes, in case you have not attempted the text and yet you are seeing this video, then please I request you to close this video now and do this test, and then now I don't think there is any need to give you the marks, okay. But yes, you please try these questions on your own. I seriously recommend you to please do the coding part, okay, not just copying it. You try to do this coding part on your own, because in your annual examination or in your half yearly examination you will be getting 60 marks for this coding only, okay. And for the section number A you will be getting only 10 to 20 marks theory portion. Rest of the portion will be from your coding part. So please, my dear students, be very serious regarding your studies. This is your board, again and again we are telling you, okay. And again, in case you are having any query, then please let me know in the comment section below. So in the next video we are going to start your unit number 8, that is your iterative constructs in Java. Furthermore, we are going to see what are the iterative constructs, what are about the loops that you might have studied in 9th class, okay. If not, then no need to worry about it. We are going to study these loops from the scratch in the next video, okay. So I hope to meet you in the next video. So till then, stay safe and keep coding. Thank you so much.